Namaste, Satnam, welcome to I Am Woke. I'm your host, Emelina. Today we're gonna go through a collective Akashic Records reading on behalf of humanity for the new moon in the middle of March. I believe it's March 13th. Really excited to get you an energy update, so let's jump right in.
Akasha is Sanskrit for ether, the substance from which all things are formed. The Akashic Records are a sacred, multidimensional library of light where there is a record or database of every thought, action, and intention for all souls. There is a record of all past, current, and future events in all timelines and all dimensional space realities.
And so we do acknowledge the forces of light. We're asking for guidance, direction, and courage to know the truth. And so it is revealed for the highest good and the highest good of everyone connected to us. O Holy Spirit of God, please protect me from all forms of self-centeredness and direct my attention to the work at hand. Help me to know humanity in the light of the Akashic Records, to see humanity through the eyes of the Lords of the Records, and enable me to share the wisdom and compassion that the Masters, Teachers, and Loved Ones of humanity have for humanity. The records are now open. Wait, hello! Oh my, we are so excited to be here again with you today! Our energy is for many of you will be amplified. We are feeling this energy as an orb or a sun. The sun is charging the energy of all of you and bringing you massive, many clusters of downloads for positivity, for engagement, for momentum in moving your life forward. We would like to communicate primarily during this new moon for you to set the new beginnings of this more fiery, uplifted, positive cycle. It is important at this time that you maintain a high level of positivity. Do not allow yourself to be dragged down, dear ones. We find that many of you, as you complain and have issues during your day-to-day life and your feelings that are not of the utmost highest frequencies, are more of an acting of sorts, dear ones. We find that many of you use complaining and what we like to call micro complaining as micro adjustments to try to actively fit in within your surroundings. For many humans have created culturally the standpoint that when another person, when you yourself are highly positive and interjected into your environment, they don't accept you. So in an adverse way of trying to fit in with your surroundings, you use micro complaining as a way to lower your own frequencies, dear ones, to fit in with those around you. At this time, we are asking you to not concern yourself with fitting in. We know that many of you consciously would say that you are not looking to blend and fit in with your surroundings, but at a subconscious level, this is what is happening. Your subconscious is actively looking to fit into your societal norms, into your family and what they find to be acceptable. And many of you pretend to be upset using micro complaining throughout the day to insert anchors into your experience that slowly lower your vibrational setting through the day until you are at the acceptable setting of your family or immediately surrounding neighbors, groups, or environment. This is not said to use as a punishment or criticism on yourselves, dear ones, but more of just an observing place for you to be able to see and experience your own conscious living and awakening in a different way. We encourage you to begin to pay more close attention to the moments where you are inserting complaining into your environment. When we say environment, we specifically mean into the interactions with your neighbors, families, and friends. When you are working and interacting with people, they could even be colleagues or bosses at work, are you toning your energy down? Do you actually want to be excited and happy and bright, but you find that you realize the other person would find that as not being an acceptable behavior, and you fear backlash or you fear standing out too much? So then there's the injection, we would say, of a micro complaint to lower the frequency to which you are vibrating to match those around you. We understand it is uncomfortable to stand out. Some of you, especially those in Aries season coming up, would say, I stand out. I have no problem being independent. And we love this about you, but actually the far majority of you are trying actively to blend in. Dear ones, we see it on quite a regular basis. Especially with the human experience. You want to fit in. It is part of the DNA codes that for your survival, your genetics need to be able to fit into groups within your environment. Knowing this will give you the capacity to remove yourself from your own experience, to be the observer as if you are stepping back from yourself and shifting over and watching your experience from another angle. From this angle, you will be able to see that the normal actions you would take, how you would interact with people that are surrounding you, can be done in a more uplifting way. That uplifting way, we would suggest a number of things now. The first would be to start giving micro compliments. Start giving micro compliments rather than micro complaining. Rather than trying to drop to the frequency of the other person near you, we suggest that you help lift and empower them to your higher frequency. It is not hard to do this, dear ones. Actually, those around you want to be lifted, but they count on your ability to empower them and to be the leader in the dynamic between your relationship. We are right in between Pisces and Aries season, which is showing the balance of the dynamic of empowering yourself and empowering others and those around you. It is about working with those in your environment to lift the frequency of all in a harmonious way to which everyone will enjoy being a part of. When you give someone a compliment in the conversation, we would suggest starting with micro compliments, like the micro complaints that is just a short, small adjustment up a frequency level. You will find that the other parties will be more open and available to begin increasing their frequency with you, dear ones. So rather than you lowering your frequency to fit in, you can maintain your stable higher frequency. And when others are around you, you can give them the opportunity to lift their frequency up to yours, dear ones, and making it very, very easy for them to do so. When you hold the space for others to be of their highest self, they will see you as a leader. They will see you as someone they look up to. They will feel good around you. And when they feel good around you, that is signifying a higher frequency. And then over time, in effect, you are continually showing these people that you are of a higher frequency. And then they become to expect to feel better around you. And then you begin to gel in creating the upward moving spiraling momentum and direction that is where you create a positive uplifting momentum and mastermind with the people around you, where everyone begins to work together to build increasing extraordinary energy. Traditionally, most of you are experiencing its opposite, where you go around people and it begins, you lower your frequency through a micro complaint and another micro complaint and another micro complaint and then a larger complaint, and you use that as a way to bond with other humans, but in effect, you're creating a negative downward spiraling frequency. This leads to you feeling burnt out, feeling like you're completely out of energy at the end of the day, feeling like those people around you are vampires. We are feeling this in our energy fields as we're talking about it, and we're not happy with this, and we're going to bring it back up and dial this whole entire interaction up. But we were telling you, dear ones, so that you can begin to understand that you have choices through your interactions with people in your environment, your family, your settings. Then each choice you have is to hold the other person to a higher standard by complimenting them, and hold yourself to your higher standard by believing that everyone around you can contribute to your own uplifting momentum so that you can continue in a highly positive manner moving forward and not to be brought down, and that those around you will begin to see you in this way and expect expect to be uplifted by and around you. It is rather magnetic and contagious, dear ones. We wish for you to understand that this positivity will create a ripple chain effect like dominoes that move through all of your experiences, your environments, and the universe at a whole, that this is a complete service to humanity, dear ones, for you to begin standing up, uplifting others, uplifting yourself to be and feel safe in being in a higher, more positive, uplifting frequency. There is a safety there that you must feel, dear ones, and then you will feel the reciprocal energy from those near and far that interact with you, where they begin to amplify your energy as well. This creates what many of you would call a snowball. We actually see it as the oceans, as a wave, where the momentum of the wave builds. And if you are surfing, dear ones, as an example, when you go to surf, you paddle to catch up with the momentum of the wave. And then at some point you stop paddling, you pop up onto the board and you ride the wave. The wave actually lifts and carries you forward. That is the momentum we are talking about, where there is so much more ease because you're maintaining the positivity. You are helping and empowering those around you to the point where you get to surf the energy of the wave that takes so much less effort because you are being carried forward in the momentum and energy of your experience in the universe. For many of you, this will be a heady conversation, so we will bring it down. When you are carried by the wave, you will experience miracles of momentum, like extra checks coming into your bank account that you didn't expect, additional gifts, small miracles, promotions. People at work will begin to see the quality of the work that you offer, the service that you offer. These will be experiences where you will have really tremendous loving relationships begin to build in your environment. People will just love you. You'll feel more loved than you've ever felt before. This is how manifesting at the higher levels of the spiritual dimension work. It is about getting in the flow of the universal energy of love and then allowing that love to carry you forward and produce the momentum for you so that you may experience all of the miracles that you've been asking for in your physical reality. The second aspect that we would recommend to you when dealing with humans in your environment is to remove criticism and remove reprimanding those around you. In replacement of reprimanding, again, we encourage you to insert compliments. They will make you feel good about yourself and you will feel good about those around you as well. Find some kindness in your heart. Find something kind to say to others and you will find that your environment will change rather quickly to one that you prefer. We know that this is a short message, dear ones, but we do appreciate your attention and our ability to transmit this message to you in this beautiful, harmonious time of positive, uplifting momentum. Thank you, dear ones. We wish all of the miraculous for you, for the beautiful energies that you have been harmoniously co-creating with to begin to manifest into your physical reality as positive, beautiful experiences that will leave you in a place of joy. Thank you, dear ones. With this, we will end our transmission. As always, I truly hope you enjoyed that message and transmission. Again, I feel super light. I love channeling. It's just like such a great tune-up for me. I hope all of that energy is communicated to you guys as well.
Almost forgot to remind you guys that this video actually builds on the previous video that was a channel from the Arcturian Galactic Council of Light that I highly recommend you go watch because they work really well together and will give you the full spectrum of what you're going to be looking for the shifts for this new moon.
As always, if you love this video, please remember to like it, drop a comment below. I would love to hear what resonated with you the most. And remember to subscribe and hit that bell for notifications so you don't miss any energy updates. Until next time, I hope you have an amazing new moon and I will see you guys soon. Man, that was so supercharged. It was just so good. It's so good. I feel so good. It feels good to feel good. I have so many videos planned, some motivational things. I'm really excited to get out on this channel. So I will be posting them shortly. And I'm gonna keep these energy updates going because they're